thank you, Al. Well, this morning we've got more of our special series we're calling Snooze You Can Use. If you have a hard time getting enough sleep, you are not alone. More than a third of Americans say they don't get the recommended 7 hours or more every night. So we wanted to hear about your biggest sleep issues, and more than 12,000 of you took our online quiz. Questions like, what time of day do you feel your best? How often do you wake up during the night? And do racing thoughts keep you awake? Resulted in these findings. 52% complained of insufficient sleep syndrome, a voluntary but unintentional lack of sleep by things like a busy schedule or stress. 18% suffer from restless leg syndrome, a neurological disorder that creates an uncomfortable and overwhelming urge to move your legs, making it difficult to fall asleep. Interrupted sleepers make up 15%. They're often woken up multiple times a night by noises like sirens, a crying baby, or a snoring spouse. While just over 11% admitted to identifying as snorers, a common issue, but heavy snoring may be a sign of a more serious disorder like sleep apnea. Surprisingly low on sleep issues was consistent insomnia, defined as having trouble falling asleep, staying asleep, and waking up too early. Dr. Rebecca Robbins is a sleep expert. She's here with new tech and gadgets that may help bring you more sleep. Dr. Robbins, good morning. Everyone can connect to this topic. So our survey was really interesting. The first thing that people talk about, trouble falling asleep. How is this a big issue for folks?
Sleep is such a critical part of our lives and plays a huge role in our waking success, but unfortunately it's a lot easier often in theory than in practice. Yeah. And trouble falling asleep is one of the most common sleep complaints. So a couple things that can help you power down. Now, light is a really important topic in the bedroom. Often we have tons of blue light devices, our cell phones, yeah, and often the lights that you can buy in the grocery store aren't optimal for sleep. So this is a cool option. Yeah. This is a light bulb that actually takes a blue light and takes transforms it to be on the warmer spectrum.
Is that what we're seeing?
Reds and yellow hues.
Okay,
yes, you can. So it's a little bit softer on the eye and allows you to read in bed before before sleep without that blue light interfering with your rest.
And what are these other things?
Also important is starting to turn off the mind and prepare the body for sleep. It's so much harder, right?
Yes.
In theory,
to relax,
in practice.
Yes.
Now these are two options. This is you press here and it starts to emit this blue light to the ceiling, and you match your breath to that light.
Oh.
A very soothing breath in and then out is the light goes down. So it takes you from about 6 breaths, mm-hmm, to less for 30 seconds.
Okay.
And now this is a more personalized option. You strap this sensor around your chest and you can start to get personal advice matched to tunes that also increase and decrease the breath and the heart rate as well before sleep.
Okay, let's move over here. Another big, big issue if you have trouble staying asleep. I call this mom sleep, interrupted sleep. So, I mean, and I've heard that it's worse to get interrupted sleep than it is. I mean, you'd be better off getting less hours that was uninterrupted.
Indeed. So fragmented sleep or trouble maintaining sleep over the course of the night is another common sleep complaint. Now, noise in the city that never sleeps,
yes,
and in New York is, of course, an important topic, but for all of us. Now, some people use white noise to help them fall asleep, just a sound in the background, such as TV static.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you came with
sound.
Yes.
But another great option developed at Northwestern Medicine is a more natural sound, the sound of a waterfall, mm-hmm, or rainfall.
Okay. There we go.
There we go.
And then just because I'm running out of time, this sheet set,
yes,
what is this?
Now, temperature also is key.
Yes.
So it's optimal to have bedding and sheets and pillows that can help you lower the temperature of your body over the course of the night. These are some sheets with moisture wicking technology.
Oh.
And this is a foam-based pillow that promotes air circulation at night.
Okay. And then last but not least, of course, snoring. Whether you snore or your bedmate snores. Big, big problem.
Yes, indeed. Now, snoring is common. About 60% of people of Americans report snoring. It can be disruptive to a bed partner, so this is a cool option. It can pick up your snoring with this device, mm-hmm, and then without doing anything, it will simply start to inflate your pillow and move your neck into a better position.
Wow, that's fancy.
Night.
And then I have 10 seconds. What are these?
A little lower cost option is to take off the adhesive strip and place it on your back. That'll keep you on your side. My grandmother would do this with a tennis ball and a sock.
Okay.
So a little bit more low tech for my grandmother. grandfather, but now this is the last snoring-related device. It's there are some barriers to continuous positive airway pressure, or CPAP, for some individuals. It's treatment for obstructive sleep apnea, people with very persistent and prolonged snoring. Now, this is an implantable device, something to talk to your physician about if you're having trouble with CPAP.
Dr. Robbins, thank you so much. I'm out of time, but actually we put all this information about these products on our website, today.com/health, so check it out. And